Hey everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a reusable cluster profile using Spectro Cloud's palette and their web UI. No code required. Over the next 20 minutes, you'll learn how to build a production-ready Kubernetes stack that you can deploy across multiple clusters with just a few clicks. You can think of a cluster profile as a blueprint. You define what your ideal cluster would look like and then deploy it as many times as you like. Actions speak louder than words, so let's dive right in. So here we are on the Spectro Cloud Palette UI. The first thing we're going to do is navigate to the Profiles section. From here, you can see that we have a button which is nicely aimed, Add a Cluster Profile. So we're going to go straight ahead and click. Now we just need to give our cluster a name. So I will call mine Production Demo. Next, we need to provide a version. So we'll go straight ahead and say that this is 1.0.0. And then I'll add a description of this is my demo cluster profile. Now there are multiple types of profiles when using Spectro Cloud's palette. First, we can choose full. This gives us an infrastructure definition for what a cluster will look like. We can define our CRI, our CNI, our CSI, the version of Kubernetes, all the stuff that goes to providing a stable and production Kubernetes cluster. The plumbing, if you will. But of course, you then need to layer stuff on top of that to get a real functioning cluster. This could be like your GitOps app delivery pipeline. It could be your observability pipeline. It could be many, many other things. So we have the choice to provide full infrastructure or just an add-on itself. For this demo, we'll do a full cluster. So now that the boarding metadata is out the way, we click Next. Now we get to decide whether we want to use Spectro to manage a managed cluster. So you can integrate with EKS, AKS, or JKE if you want to. But I feel the real value here is getting to define every layer within my cluster. It is important to me what my CSI is, what my CNI is, and I don't like that all these managed clusters give me a dodgy CNI where I have to chain on Cilium. So we're going to go with a JCP IaaS cluster. This just means we're going to use Google Cloud to provide the infrastructure, but we'll manage everything else ourselves. From here, I can choose the operating system that I wish to use. Now you can BYOS, bring your own operating system, but we're going to keep things simple today and just choose Ubuntu. We can then choose the version that we wish. 2204 will work just nicely for me. And if you want to, you can hook in and start to modify the user data provided to the nodes as they come online. I don't need to do anything like this today, so we'll just go to the next layer. Now the fun bit. I get to choose that I want to run Cilium. Not AWS CNI, not the JKE CNI, where you charge you for Hubble. I get Cilium, and that is important to me. Now, what's important here is that we have a README and a values file. So no surprises here that what we're getting is a Cilium Helm install. So if you want to go in and understand all the values and tweak it to be perhaps kube proxy free, if you can spell proxy, we can eventually find the kube proxy replacement and set it to true. When you have Cilium with eBPF, we don't need no proxy. So I love the flexibility that I can modify the values applied to this chart to get me the version of Cilium that I want to use. Let's go to the next layer. Now we have to choose our storage or CSI. Now, while I could go rogue and run something like MyaStore, which is a very cool project, I am using GCP. So So it probably would be remiss of me if I didn't just use Google Cloud Disks, because there's a lot of value to plugging these into our nodes. And I'm not going to turn that up. We also have the values file if you do want to go and modify the CSI deploy. I'm quite happy just to say confirm. Now we can see that we have all these layers within our profile. We have our CSI, our CNI, the version of Kubernetes that we wish to deploy, and our operating system. Now, of course, if I want to modify any of these, I can just click. And maybe I don't want to run the latest and greatest version of Kubernetes for whatever reason, and I decide that I just want to run 130.11. Now we get to see a diff of what is changing in our cluster. We can see that it's modifying the control plane components that will be deployed, and we can confirm if we are happy with these changes. So let's click yes. We then click confirm updates, and we get back to our review screen. Now you can use this screen at any point. If we click next and save this, like so, you'll now see it's been added to my cluster profile list. I can just click on this and continue to make changes over time. Okay, now before we make any more changes to this profile, let's go back to the profile page and say add a new one. We want to add a monitoring stack to our cluster, but we want to make this composable and reusable by anyone within the organization. We set this to version 1, we call it an add-on, we click next. From here, we can say add a new pack. I can search for Prometheus, give that just a moment. And I'm going to choose Prometheus Grafana. Now I could go headfirst into this and start slinging some YAML in here, looking for the things that I know are a problem. But there are some niceties provided by the Palette UI. At the top right here, you'll see we have access to presets and variables. So on presets, if we know that we need to monitor GPUs, the NVIDIA GPUs, we could click yes, and the values file will be updated. Or we can disable and it'll be updated again. We can turn on email alerts, enable ingress for Grafana, turn on Fanos sidecars, use object storage, etc., etc. So these presets are configured for a variety of the packs, just to make sure that you've got an easy, convenient way of turning on the features you need without having to read hundreds, if not thousands, of lines. Thousands of lines of YAML. Now, if I click confirm here, we'll get an error telling us that our Grafana admin password is not set. So let's search for admin password and we'll type. And another nicety has revealed itself. You don't know what the password is. Now this is a very nice touch as well. We've been able to come in here and modify a password, and I can set this to anything I want, and it isn't visualized within the editor. So let's delete this and try a different approach. What if we want to use a variable? Let's call this Prometheus Grafana password. And I should learn how to spell. Now, of course, for us, this will be a string, but we also have access to numbers, booleans, versions, IP addresses, and ciders. We could specify where we want custom input validation, as the help text shows us this is just a regex that we can define. It has to be a minimum number of characters, it has to have a mixture, whatever we need to do. We can say that this is required. We can provide a default value if we want. And we can decide to mask this value like so. So we'll hit create. We can then copy this and paste. And now let's click confirm and create our monitoring profile. Awesome. Now let's come back to our production demo. And at the top right, what we're going to do is click deploy. We will call this our demo cluster. Choose my Google account. And now we can choose our cluster profile. As you can see, this is the exact cluster profile with the version of Kubernetes that we selected, and we click Next. I can deploy this to a project. I can deploy it to a region. And I have a control plane and a worker pool. So let's assume I want a 3-node highly available control plane. I can choose the instance type, like so. And then I have my worker pool where we'll turn on auto scaling to a maximum of 10 nodes. For this, I will choose compute, like so. We'll stick these in best one and hit next. Now I get to define our maintenance settings. So do I want to be able to patch the operating system? Let's do it on a Sunday. What could go wrong on Monday morning? Do we want to do scans? Security scans? Penetration scans and testing? And conformance testing. Again, let's run it all on Sunday. What's the worst that could happen? These scans are hooking in to open source projects like KubeBench, KubeHunter, and Sonoboy. We can validate our configuration, and I get that this cluster is going to cost me just under $3 per hour. Let's click Finish. Now, while this spins up, why don't we have a quick conversation? Now, some of what you're seeing may feel a little bit familiar, and that's because Palette by Spectro Cloud is built on top of Cluster API. So when we're adding a provider like the GCP IaaS one, this is using Cluster API GCP, the same for Azure and AWS. What's nice about what Palette provides is new primitives for building fully fledged clusters. We're able to define our add-on packs and our infrastructure together or separately and compose them in a way that makes sense for each unique cluster that we are deploying to our environment. This becomes more apparent as we need to make a change to our cluster, and we'll see that in just a moment's time. You know, as someone who previously worked at Equinix Metal helping with their cluster API implementation, I can hands down say that this is the nicest approach and interface I have ever seen to cluster API. So I hope you enjoy what you're seeing. I hope you can see the power and the flexibility behind the product. And I hope that you want to keep watching to see more. So let's head back and check on that cluster. Awesome. Now that our cluster is running, let's go to the Profile tab, where we can add our add-on as a new layer. We'll select our monitoring stack, like so. Now, if we click Review and Save, it'll tell us that we are about to deploy the Prometheus It shows us that we are about to deploy Prometheus. We can review these changes in their editor, but because this is new, there is no current configuration. We can also set our password because we made this a variable when we created the add-on. We can hit apply and done. If we hover over, we'll see that the installation is in progress. So we'll give that a few seconds, but while that's running, let's go back to our profile. And actually, I've decided we should probably make a change. So let's edit the pack. And what we'll do is we'll search for pod monitor. We want to turn on a selector that says, you know what, we only want to monitor pods where Prometheus is enabled. We can say match labels, Prometheus, true. So let's confirm our updates and save our changes. Now we can add a note saying that we only want to scrape pods with a Prometheus true label and save. Now here we can see that our demo cluster is using this add-on. So we will click on that. And at the top right, you'll see we have some updates to apply to this cluster. So let's click. And it's telling us there's a new version of our monitoring stack add-on. So let's review the changes. We can see that now the pod monitor has a label selector. So we can choose to apply these changes to our cluster. It really is as simple as that. Palette from Spectro Cloud gives you the nicest experience for managing one or many clusters with the configuration that you want on the cloud provider that you want. It really is Kubernetes your way, not the hard way. And to anyone watching us going,
the ClackOps, think of the children.
Don't worry, join us for the next video as we take a look at doing this with YAML and Git. And then the next video where we take a look at doing this with Terraform. So if you vibe more with that, go check out those videos next. We'll see you next time.